Max doing right now. I said, oh, we're about to do an interview.
That's cap. That's, I didn't hear a phone call.
He's like, yeah, a bunch of shorties called me when I was
there. Yeah, like 12 FaceTimes, man. I'm not talking to two of them.
Phone blowing up right now.
Yeah, I hit the clown a couple of
times. Don't spam that red button. Oh, come on,
man. Stop, man.
I swear, as soon as I walk out of the room, the clown just caught me.
Don't be fucking with my young. Them niggas be drumming. They take your ass down, shit, we need them bricks or something. Keep this shit 100, I keep this shit 300. I pull up in that Audi, you pull up in that Honda. A fuck nigga don't wanna.
Alright, so we got customer service here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude.
And I'm gonna start with the basics. The basics.
Alright.
Alright, where's the name come from?
Essentially, the story is, so me and him worked at Canadian Tire together,
okay,
and we worked on the customer service desk, mm-hmm, and then one day, one of us, don't know who, was like, oh, this is called the band Customer Service, and it pretty much just came from that. Yeah, the original band name was Rug. Actually, we were sitting in this room, and we wrote our first song, Drunk Darts, and we were like, what do we call the band? Rug.
We kind of all hated it, and we kind of all loved it, and so like that was the original name,
mm-hmm,
but then that was like a quick thing. We made like one song, and then our friend just like went away, and then now we're like, now then Owen and I tried to like reestablish something new.
Okay, were you guys in the picture at that point?
No, so they joined like 4 months ago.
Yeah.
4 months? You guys are, oh wow.
Yeah. Well, we only missed like two shows though.
Yeah. Four.
Four
shows.
But no, me and Max.
Three, we'll call it three.
Okay, I'll call it an even three. But no, me and Max have been playing together in like in a band for like 2.5 years.
And so the other guys left.
Yeah.
And then you brought in your cousin, Nick.
No, not even. There was another guy in between the first two guys
that
came again.
It's a big story.
So this, it took two of us to make up for that one guy.
Yeah.
He was a bassist and a vocalist.
Okay, yeah. Crazy.
What we had, well, originally, like, when Owen and I would just write, I wrote a lot of songs trying to, like, mix a lead and rhythm part together. And it's this weird style, but it works for one guitar. And then the old guy we had, his name's Liam. When he was playing with us, he just
shout
played.
Shout out Liam.
Yeah, shout out Liam.
Liam's a good dude, too.
Sick guy, yeah. Crazy musician.
Man, honestly, cheers to Liam.
Cheers to Liam.
Let's go, Liam. Cheers, Liam, man, wherever you are right now.
Oh, yeah, so when I was writing guitar parts, I tried to, like, write a lot of, like, the lead and rhythm together. And then when we moved forward and, like, brought in Matt, it was like we kind of had to reestablish, well, break up my parts, figure out, like, how to place two guitars on top of each other and still, like, have the same sound, but, like, spread it out a bit more.
Okay.
And so there's parts where, like, I'm not playing or parts where he's not playing, but when we're, like, really trying to pack in some energy, where it's, like, all four of us are just going wild.
But yeah, with that, it'll be, like, me doing, like, a lot of, like, strumming, just, like, rhythm, and, like, he'll be doing, like, a lead, like any sort of, like, picking and, like, just, like, a riff.
Like, okay, putting the vocal melody over top on a guitar, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So that would be, like, the main thing you're hearing, and then there's a bit of that in the background?
Yeah, it's just, like, strumming, just, like, almost, like, filling out the sound, I guess. Yeah. Like, yeah.
Just as, like, an honest-to-God mindset, when you guys are on stage, are you, like, I'm here to entertain, I'm here because this music is fucking awesome, or is it a bit of both?
And it's definitely a bit of both. It's always been super important to be, like, this is a show, and we're putting it on for people.
Okay.
So whether that's like figuring out like funny lines in between songs, like little skits. Like at one of our shows, he wore a suit and he wore a prom dress, and yeah,
that
and
is
I sung a, I sung a John Legend song while he played it on bass.
See, that's smart too, because that's like trying to keep people entertained in like an era of short attention spans.
Exactly.
You know, people that are like going to a show, and I'm sure if you're drunk, you can kind of like watch anything, but that is like something you're going to remember. That's something you're going to wake up the next day and be like, yo, these guys slow dance while playing.
Yeah, John Legend.
Exactly. Yeah.
I don't forget that moment.
I think before the show, he was more scared about the slow dance than actually playing.
very much so, yeah.
It's honestly like, nice having those skits because then, yeah, you like all your anxiety is just about
the skit.
The skit.
Yeah.
It's like, you kind of, you're like, oh, just, you know, the show's one thing. We've rehearsed the show. We didn't even know what song they were going to do for the
yeah,
song.
Yeah, we didn't tell them
they
the song.
They wouldn't tell us, you know, so we were just like, all right, there's going to be a slow dance at some point. That was it.
For the camera, we don't plan the skits. They're all spontaneous.
Yeah. And so before you guys do a show, is there some kind of huddle?
Dude, yeah.
We've worked through so many different rituals, like pre-show rituals. Like yeah. The first show, it was just kind of us sitting in the basement while like the other bands were playing. It was like a house show. First show that it was this formation, obviously.
The
not.
First show.
That it was all this formation.
When it was the real band.
Yeah, when it was the, yeah.
No, don't knock on wood, motherfucker. Yeah, this is the real band.
This is.
But we like sat in the basement while like, the other bands were playing upstairs, and we all like painted each other's nails.
That is cute. Yeah.
But no, it was like, pretty cute.
I gave you guys like a sick like football prep talk.
Yeah,
no, it was like yeah, pre-game was football pump up, and yeah. Then we just like screamed at each other. And
so you were like, "Let's go, boys!" Let's
oh, it was a full thing. A bit of high school football came out of me. A bit of my rugby came out, and I just like screamed at them.
It's always like. The four of us get into a space where it's just us, and we kind of just talk for a second, which is the best way to do it. Like, we all just kind of like, yo, like, because it's natural. Like, we're all a little nervous before, so we just kind of get it all out and fucking just talk it through for a second, and
that's
then we're
fair.
All good to go out.
That's a, yeah. That's because you guys, where have you guys played? What was the first show of you four?
The first show, we did us, the four of us. Yeah, Jennings Street, right there.
It was a house show.
Yeah.
And in your opinion, opposed to a place like that's like a venue that you're booking, is it usually more chaotic?
Oh yeah.
Better in every sense.
Like
it, I don't know.
Playing actual venues, like you have a guy doing a sound guy, there's actual sound check. But for house shows, there's like a, it's kind of like a magic about them where it's like everyone there is like people who you're like friends with or a friend of a friend. So everyone there wants you to do well, and it's always just like great energy, man. And
those are like the real fans that are showing
exactly,
up.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you feel personally more comfortable?
Oh yeah, for sure.
And why? Why? Just because it
just
is the main fans?
Like, just because it's yeah, it's all people you know. Mm-hmm. You just let anything fly. It's just way more comfortable.
Right.
Whereas in like a venue, there's kind of like an expectation to like play well.
Right.
And yeah, in a house show, you just let it fly, which ends up actually usually making it better.
Because I've seen a lot of live performances where it's the song that you all know, but they do a little bit of a change.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And that's probably important to you guys.
That's how we love play. Every time we play any of our songs live, it's different every time.
It's all improv.
Yeah.
It's like the energy is just like, it's variable, so it's not like the same thing. It's not just like you're doing what you've rehearsed. Mm-hmm. You're like feeling it because it's new. Mm-hmm. And so like you're more likely to kind of just like let a line be like screamed or like, you know what I mean? Or
something
just, like,
that's a little different.
Yeah,
though.
It sounds, and it just feels better too, you know?
Okay, but do you feel more likely to do that at a house show than?
Yeah, definitely. Okay. Yeah. I mean, like experimenting in general at a house show is just so much easier because you're
less
just like
pressure.
Yeah, like you feel like you have to be like technically good at a bar. Like you're like, there's people there. It could be anybody there. You
know,
you want to impress people and all that, so.
And like maybe that can be kind of jarring for a fan, be like, oh, I don't recognize that little chord hit there. What's that little number?
Mm-hmm. I mean, like, that's the beauty of us not having anything released yet. No one knows.
Yeah,
no one
knows. Yeah. Because were you guys friends before the band?
We've known each other for 16 years.
I was recruited through Facebook Marketplace.
Like, hi, I'm looking to sing.
I just like joke that like it's weird to know that you like found one of like your closest friends on Marketplace. Yeah. I think that like one of the people I spend the most amount of time with, I just like found on an ad, replied to my band posting ad. I think like, that's so weird.
I was like, yo, you guys still looking for guitarists?
Like,
yeah, I
know. Just, like these guys are like, you know, on stage, like they're like my guys. Like I fucking love them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They're so good at what they do. Yeah, but like for real.
So my brother and his girlfriend were like away on vacation and they like sent me an ad and they were like, yo, like this band is looking for a guitarist, a bassist, and a vocalist. So I reached out and like that day when I reached out, you guys like came and picked me up. They also lived like two blocks away, which was so funny. They're like, yeah, we'll come pick you up. And, like it was like in the middle of a snowstorm. You guys
never met.
Kind of funny.
And did you find that the connection right away when you got into the car?
Yeah, I mean, at first, I like went outside and he was like driving a Mini Cooper. I was like, oh, that's pretty sick. Look at him. So like, we go to their basement and like we were jamming a bit, and they were like, do you want to try singing? And I was like, I was just like nervous. I was like, yeah, sure. And I was like, so I sang, and luckily it was, you know, good enough. and so then I just ended up kind of staying on as the singer.
You guys good for beers right now?
Oh, weird.
Yeah,
I'm good.
Yeah. I'll get a backup.
Yeah,
I'm not trying to get fucked up.
Dude, I'm already over the edge right now. You guys good? You should.
I got a tequila like right before you guys came. I got egged on. Did I egg myself on? I think I egged myself on.
Well, I was egging you on to give me the last shot, and then you took it yourself.
So if you guys need one, just give me the thumbs up and I'll pass you one if you're talking about something.
What's the word?
This is a very blessed, like, first, like, I'm actually very happy.
I'm so glad, like,
we're your first interview, but you're also ours.
It's like a crazy moment.
Fuck pigs.
Oh. Yeah, fuck the pig.
Hey, I'll grab it.
I don't have shame. Not for drinking.
I'll toss
this one a little closer. I want to make peace. I want to make love.
Is it safe to say I'm the most critical in the band?
Yeah.
And so what's your definition of critical?
Oh, just like, I feel like we don't practice enough. Like everything's like,
despite the fact we practice all the time.
He's the only one without a job right now.
But he's putting devotion into something.
But I see the passion of everybody else and the commitment. And like, you're like your 12-step plan to success or whatever it is. Step and it's like the same thing as Matt, where like we go to shows and they're just consistently getting better. People are getting into them more.
So
and
you find fight critical, you're like, we gotta practice and make sure it's tighter.
Like everybody had hope and I didn't. But now I'm getting up.
That's good, man.
Getting up there.
We're working him.
I
believe.
I don't think, man, you can't belittle him, man. That's true. Really, though.
You got to keep on track.
The team mentioned, like, the 12-step plan. It was something, it's actually 13 steps.
Oh,
sorry. Yeah. It's not that easy to be successful.
Yeah.
It's not 12.
Yeah, it's not 12, it's 13. It was like a 13-step plan to becoming, like, a known, it's not even to be, like, famous, to be a known local band. And we're, like, when I wrote it, I was like, we're never actually going to do anything. And we're on, like, step 8 right now, which is pretty fucked up.
And he made this whole note, this whole section, he, like, pinned it to the top. It was, like, the 13-step plan. I'm like, you're an idiot. Like, why are you making this 13-step plan? And then I just, like, made fun of him for it. And then, like, the other day, he was like, yeah, we're working on step number 8. I'm like, what? And then this like flashback to the whole plan, and then like kind of talking about it, it's like I had no intention of making it past like 3. I like read the list, and it's kind of cool just to like see these numbers grow and to like bring that back in. And I'll probably forget about it again, and then I'll be like at step 10, and then it'll just be like another cool thing. But
our first bar show we did, we sold out Gus's, which was like 150. Yeah, thank you. Now we're on to like the next thing, which is like the goal, working on doing like a marquee show.
Yeah,
like packing
marquee
that
would be
out.
Awesome. Yeah, be yeah. Mm-hmm. We did a show at Marquee. He was doing DJ, I was recording, and Ben was
really
performing. It was awesome. It was open for Jazz Cartier.
Oh, fuck yeah.
He's an A. What?
Yeah,
that's sick.
It was fucking awesome, man. Like, you guys at Marquee would fucking kill it.
Yeah, well, there's a good amount of shows, like our first few shows, where like we would be like, oh, that was really good. And Nick was like, yeah, it was good.
Right. Yeah, so even last night.
Nick, are you searching for like perfect?
Yeah.
You're always
That's
looking
what you
for
should always search for.
Yeah, I agree.
There's also where Nick's been playing bass like very seriously for like 15, 16 years probably. Mm. So he's like just technically as a musician, he's obviously like he's very much the best in the band.
Takes the cake.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Yeah. Like he's an animal. Yeah.
Like he's a fucking beast on the bass.
Thanks, man.
Okay, I'm going to press this button.
Alright,
yeah,
we gotta get an angle of that ass for a
second. Yeah, just get some ass. On the topic of how recently we're all playing, I just have to shout out these two guys. So these two guys have only been playing for 3 years, right? Two and a half years?
Three, two.
All
and
self-taught.
Half.
It's just insane how quickly like they're getting good.
It was just like me and him sitting in my basement, like my parents' basement, trying to write songs, and that's how we got, you know. I don't want to say good, but like,
except
where you are now. Where you are now.
Yeah.
The other day, Owen hops off the kit for like 2 seconds, and his dad just like comes out of nowhere, not even through the door. Like he just like came
through
the curtains of the basement. He just sits down at the kit. We were just like kind of jamming around like a couple chords, and his dad just sits down on the kit. He just starts like just kind of feeling it, and just like slowly gets so into it, and then he just like rips. And we were all like.
But you're still playing.
Yeah, we're still playing. Like, we had a 15 minute jam session with Owen's dad on
and
drum.
So you just stepped aside.
I was like, fuck it, man. He's like, shout out Jake.
Shout out Jake.
He's
Uncle Jake.
Cheers to Jake. Cheers to Jake.
Cheers to Jake.
Let's go, Jake.
I consider myself, you know, Nova Scotia.
Farewell to Nova Scotia, the sea bound coast. Let your mountains dark and dreary be.
If you're if you wrote a song from start to finish, yeah. Are you nervous presenting it?
Yeah, man.
How do you feel though?
Because they're all so
yeah,
good.
If you so most of them, it'll be like, I'll write it start to finish. It'll be like chords and vocals. And then I'll bring it in and I'll be like, Max, figure out a lead part. Nick, figure out a bass part. Owen, figure out a drum part. I like woke up one morning and was like laying in bed and my guitar was in the other room. And I was just like, I don't know, didn't have the energy to like go get it. So yeah, I was like laying in bed and I was just like thinking about a song. And so I just started writing, and then like just slowly, I don't even know, it just kind of happened. And then like 3 hours later, I was like, okay, I'm gonna go get the guitar and try and see if this actually works. And it worked. And then so that for me, it was like a full song. But at that point, it was so like conceptualized in my head that I was like, I had all the parts. I mean, probably minus the bass part, to be honest. I didn't really have a bass part. Max ended up adding a riff like in the bridge and like stuff like that. But like little bits like that, and then like that was like the one where I was like, oh, I have a drum part in mind, which was tough.
Why are you tough on it?
You're tough on the ego. Job. It's hard for the ego.
Yeah, man. Just
he didn't get the jam like the Owen way. It was like, oh, this is what I want it to be, you know?
Yeah.
But like,
and honestly, too, like to give Matt his credit, like the drum part he had in his head was the right part from the minute.
But you wanted.
But for me, I just wanted to be like, I'm gonna fuck around this and do this like 20 different ways, and then I eventually landed on the thing he came up with anyway.
Yeah.
It's a song called Love Punk. And actually, when we played it last night, opening for the band Diglo Abortions, there was someone in the front row, actually, after we played it, yelled, that's a fucking sick song!
Yeah, really?
So,
I didn't hear that.
Yeah. Okay, Max, what's the reason why, speak for the band, you guys aren't, what you think as a band, you guys aren't on Spotify and major streaming platforms yet?
Slightly, due to, like, being like perfectionists.
It's also just like mic quality of room, like the room, like I don't know how much, like in terms of music production, like right, like making rap, like it's like the production aspect of it, like it's not like making beats is obviously
it's
hard
different.
Like you don't need to put like a ton of money into a room and mic quality because you're taking samples,
right,
or like using a drum machine. Recording live drums is something that, like, to get a good quality like drum takes for an album, like 10 songs, would probably run you a minimum of like $800. Mm-hmm. You gotta go into an actual studio to get that like at a good quality.
The only advice I would give, because I'm surrounded by people that make music,
yeah,
and it is different because the people that I'm surrounded with make hip hop.
Yep. Yeah.
It's different. It's a beat that's made on a computer,
yeah,
and you just go on a mic, and so it's different. However, you're not gonna put out music that's gonna be like fucking perfect right away.
Yeah, exactly.
No,
yeah.
Yeah.
But
we've
gotta put out something that's like holy shit, and you see the gradual like incline in fucking quality.
It's very much just a thing of like rock music, like the production. You need to put money into it to a certain extent,
right?
Even if that's just renting good mics. And also, we are all kind of on the understanding of like, when we put out something, we want to have a bit more of a following too,
right?
So it gets to, like, the initial song gives us that bit more of a boost.
Yeah
because the sound has changed a lot.
Oh man, a lot. Yeah.
We sound a lot more fucked up before you guys joined.
Nick, yeah, I guess, yeah, give it to Nick.
Okay.
Give the floor to Nick.
Okay. Well,
these two guys are kind of wild. They're kind of feral.
Mm-hmm. Matt, especially, and I are kind of reserved and technical, would you say?
Yeah.
Sure. Indie. Soft.
It's usually the quiet guys that are usually the more like John Frusciante, like from Chili Peppers.
Yep.
So fucking like precise.
Peppers. Yeah. And like as much as like where Nick will be like critical, there's a lot of the times where I'll find myself being like, yeah, and I think we had this conversation like literally last night or like two nights ago where I was like, as much as I want us to be like, you know, tight and good as a band, some of the like mess is also like, mm-hmm, in my opinion, a big part of our sound.
Yeah.
Like, I like a little bit of like chaos.
Right.
I like it to be like there's structure. We know like where all the sections of each song are. You know, we know what we're doing, but there's chaos in it all. You know what I mean? There's like,
I feel
still
like the pair of us have been balancing out the pair of you guys.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, because before, our old like vocalist and bassist was just like me and Max. And it was
chaos.
Very chaos.
It's like Nick has a sick YouTube channel. Embrace, shout out to Embrace.
Shout out Embrace the Bass.
Subscribe to Embrace the Bass.
Yeah.
<But, like, laughs> loud, fast, aggressive.
There's definitely a gap in which, like, Nick and I are on one side and you guys are on the other. Like, yeah. I feel like Nick and I could, like, sit down and listen to Steely Dan all day. I don't know if you guys could do that.
So we'll start with Max here, all right? Just, like, I just am genuinely, if you're out and about and you're walking, you're by yourself, okay? You're walking, you're going to point A to point B. What is, like, the most common thought that you have running through your head? And it, and don't get boxed in from, like, the band thing. Just, like, for me, it's, like, looking back on, like, cringe things that I'm, like, how can I never do that again? Like,
hands down, either, like, the last girl I messaged on Tinder or the band. Like, those two things. I'm like, damn, did it? Did I send the wrong first message? Am I actually gonna get her number?
If you're from point A to B, what's, like, mostly going on your head?
I genuinely do not know. I have to put myself in
the
mindset right now.
It can be cut from
that's the most. That's the most Nick answer ever.
I don't know.
I just have to picture I'm walking down the street.
You're walking.
Man, this guy walks with groove. He's a bass player. Everything he does has a bit of groove in it.
I don't know. I guess I'm just thinking about the day, thinking about what I have to do, what has to get done.
In that day.
What has to get
done? It's not outside that you're constantly, like.
No.
Interesting.
Yeah, what do I have to do?
See, that's interesting, though. Yeah. Because that's, like, if you sent them a message on Tinder, for example, the night before, you're thinking about that.
I'm not, like,
that's old news.
I'm
old news.
That's old news.
He's thinking about the message he's about to send.
Yeah. He's like, what do
he's
I send this time?
He's one step ahead of the game.
So you're walking to point 8B, you're just, like, things that normally go through your head.
Oh, like, you know, blah, 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 school girls. I'm always, like, thinking about...
Wait, school girls?
School girls.
School, no, period.
School. I would love to get school girls.
Point A to point B, like, I'm always just got, like, music on, or I'm thinking about the band, or, like, there's not much time where I'm shutting off, and I'm, like, just thinking about, you know, what's happening.
Are you plugging the music to stop you from thoughts, or are you, like, just, I just want to do that?
I just want to listen to music, and I always, when I listen to music, I'm always thinking about, like, me on stage playing drums, like, you know, I'm in Led Zeppelin, you know.
Going crazy.
Yeah, exactly.
You're looking for inspiration as you're going
exactly,
from point A to point
yeah.
B. All right, here we go. Matt.
And, like, I'll, like, listen to music and hear an artist, like, singing about a certain, like, event or something that's, like, you know, everybody experiences, and I'm like, oh, that's the way that they see that certain event, mm-hmm. or see that certain, like, and I will, like, pause music, and, like, a lot of time I'll, like, take out the notes app or something and, like, you know, start, like, writing, like, lyrics that kind of, oh, I've experienced that before, but I didn't, like, think about it the same way that this artist thought about it, so I'll, like, write the way that I thought about it. I don't know, I think about people's perceptions and the way that people just, yeah, think about day-to-day things, the way that everybody has their own view on everything. It's the combination of their entire life, and I'll just, like,
it's a combination of, like, what their life has built up to that point.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. And so, like, I feel like that, like, even just walking down the street and just seeing, like, the way people will walk, or the way people will, like, avert their eye, like, not try to make eye contact. And, like, I just think about, I don't know, the way that everybody is just, like, everybody is a full fucking person, you know what I mean? And
I agree,
and
man.
I can't shut that off. Like, when I'm walking down a busy street, I'm just like, these are, like, full people.
These are people, like, it's crazy. To me, if you look at an apartment building, lights are on in certain buildings, lights are off.
They got LEDs, like, they got lamps. They, like, you know, they don't
fucked.
Have the lights on. It's like,
it's like that person is awake for this reason and they're thinking this thing.
Yeah, I mean, I always have my AirPods in. It's like that kind of thing where I always have
this
music
got
going.
The AirPods
yeah,
in.
Got the AirPods in.
Yeah. Are they AirPod Pros?
I don't have the pros.
Are they pros though?
No.
Are they pros?
Not pros.
That's
crazy.
Not pros.
Everyone good for beer?
I need to just go.
Go. Yeah, go.
Oh, sorry.
Remember we can
go. Oh, now he's really in the back.
I'm thinking about this.
I'm talking. He talked out loud. Listen in the headphones.
Yeah, you guys gonna listen. Compare our streams.
11:35.
What time? We started 11. Yeah. Also, talk about a message on Tinder.
Does that, like, classic shit, but, like, he
I know it's
just like interview mode.
I only just stopped recording now. That whole time, we have a combo between the audio of this.
I saw you smiling.
Pissing the whole time. Watching you guys talk.
I took my mic off and I was holding it.
I was literally listening.
What you gotta do?
Mute.
Oh, my God.
Oh, he's insecure about his stream.
We've been drinking an unhealthy amount recently.
I don't know. So the crazy thing is, to me, I'm in Walmart today.
Okay.
Yeah, let's hear it.
I'm in Walmart.
Yeah.
I hate Walmart.
Everybody hates Walmart.
Walmart is fucking strange.
Yeah.
It's like, I was about to say something, but I'll wait. I simply don't know if I've seen a living human in Walmart.
It's just like lizard people.
Like bots.
NPCs. NPCs.
Where bots go and NPCs go to be like, oh, you're an NPC.
Yeah. It's like on a mission. They're following their like guided path.
I looked at every single person I saw in Walmart today. I wasn't confident that they were alive.
Like, were you tripping balls? They're like, what's going on?
Hey, dude, do they think the same thing about you?
That's the shit that I think
about.
Do they think the same thing about you?
I don't know, though.
Am I an NPC to these people, or do they realize that I'm like the fucking
I'm living.
Character?
I'm pissed. No, but I don't know, man. The way they be gliding down the ice cream like aisle, just fucking like, oh yeah, Scotsman, that's the move. I don't know, bro. The way they're like moving down the section, I'm like, they can't be real, man.
But those are the people with like the least inhibitions. I'm just like, oh, so you guys are just like actually chilling. Like you guys are actually like existing. Like I can't just exist like you. I can't do what you're doing right now.
It's the dude trapped in a world.
Truman Show.
Have you seen Truman Show?
No, is it Jim Carrey?
Yeah.
I can't, bro. I'll be too fucked
up.
I can't. It'll fucking like freak me out.
But if you're like, if you can't watch it, like, don't watch it.
No, I can't, man.
Even if you can't watch it.
I'm, like, grabbing onto the hope that there's, like, fucking something, man.
Truman Joe will, like, you'll be pushed over the edge. I like thinking that I'm affecting other people with my decisions. because then if that wasn't the case, then I'd be, like, no anxiety, completely unhinged. Mm, so.
True. I'm going to grab another beer.
Oh, yeah.
I need another one, too, actually. Yeah.
Thumbs up.
You want one?
I got a cube. I got an ice cube.
Oh, yeah.
That's going in the
beer. This is the way it should go, man. You want
one? Too, yeah.
Wait, let me give you the cold one.
Okay, okay.
Dude, I'm like doing audio back here. I'm trying my best not to burst out laughing.
Talking about NPCs in Walmart.
I don't know, man. Just the lighting at Walmart, man.
I go to fucking Walmart.
Let's talk about the lighting at Walmart.
We go to Walmart together, and we're in the chip aisle, and we're buying some shit.
Yeah.
We're looking around. We're like, hey, yo, we're playing Skyrim right now.
Don't get me started on Skyrim.
Yeah, don't get us started on Skyrim.
We're like, this shit is not real.
I almost failed junior high because of Skyrim.
Stepped out of this... Are we done?
Oh, we're done.
We'd get into fights about...
Because I was super into World of Warcraft.
Because of Nick.
World of Warcraft, baby.
Yeah.
Oh, and that's
chasing
what I feel like
high, man.
Every time I play... Every time I play...
Chasing the high, man.
Of Skyrim.
Chasing the dragon.
Skyrim's the closest I can get to him, man.
I'm just waiting
for that next Elder Scrolls to drop, man.
Elder Scrolls 6. It's going to change my life,
I've been waiting.
2025.
Xbox, like, Microsoft bought Bethesda.
Yeah.
So it's probably going
to be... Yeah, bro.
I got a fucking PS5.
Hey, I got an Xbox, man. I got an Xbox.
Getting married in Skyrim was the best moment of my life.
Oh, man.
Sims, bro, you can woohoo.
Man, I went all day every day.
Jeez,
shit was wild, man.
Are you on Clash Royale? It's like Fortnite?
No, fuck Fortnite.
What do you mean like Fortnite? Come on.
It's like Battle Royale.
Is it Minecraft?
No, yeah, you know Clash of Clans?
We've won every Clash Clan War, okay? We've won every Clan War.
Sit on the couch.
Custom service.
You sit on that couch.
Sign up. Join our clan.
We found the couch in the dumpster. Oh,
you wouldn't join those?
They're playing Clash of Clans, man. I don't know.
Clash Royale.
He's too old. He doesn't get it. He's too old.
I'm not trying to make
it. You know, I gotta take a pause for a sec. I'll show you after, but you can visually see on the DAW how many beers you guys have had by how big the wave
was. Should we start climbing?
Is this getting louder?
Get everything.
Well, we're on a bit of a break.
If you can bounce, I'll work on it.
Yo, Max, can you get the vape?
Buddy, look.
Yeah, I kind of want to get my duct tape.
We don't care at all.
Dude, it's all good.
It's our vibe.
I overthink it.
Don't even bring it off.
Oh, yeah.
Every time. What did you guys do to my
Nothing phone? Happened.
Do you, where's the vape?
This is getting chaotic.
Oh, fuck.
I feel like the interview ended like 20 minutes ago.
It didn't, though. That's the thing. It didn't. It didn't.
Yeah. No, nothing bro, that's what, right? It's about yeah, whatever.
I like recently been trying to.
Podcasts are good for drives, but I haven't been driving a lot.
I drive for work. I
will.
Disney's doing good for Star Wars, man.
No!
Like that. And he runs right into the brand. Into I know, I couldn't believe it.
And I was like, oh, I can't believe it.
We have Star Wars, don't bring up Star Wars. Yeah, we
get base.
Yeah.
That was cool.
Even
five.
Literally.
Is Hayden Christensen? Yeah. In the Vader suit, like that's not James Earl Jones. They have his
Nick,
voice,
you gotta help
they
me.
They overlay it over.
Start grabbing cans and taping them together.
They
it's we're gonna it's gonna be a big cut and then it's gonna be a stack of beers. And I'm four episodes in.
I think Disney the best thing they're doing right now is Star Wars, but I just mean more Marvel.
Doesn't have to fit. Okay. This is gonna be in the house. This is a house centerpiece.
Where's he from? What province?
We've been like pushing. Who didn't finish their fucking beer?
Oh no, it's because you have an upside down one. That's why.
You moron.
No, there's a couple upside down ones. You have a bunch of upside down ones.
They're all upside down.
Now it's just going the other way.
Now they're all good.
Again and again. And like if I can, if there is a way that I could do that.
Right.
I'm done at the beer tower, man. What the fuck?
Sheesh.
Sheesh.
Okay, so what we'll do with this beer, this rope of beer, is me and Rob will hop sketch it.
Hop sketch.
Oh my god.
When are they expected to open up Spotify and be like, I'm gonna open up?
There's no date.
Oh god.
There's no date.
Like, when do you think though?
September-ish.
No, I did.
But like, we still like, we want to have something that's like, we're kind of, like, I don't know, proud of like the recording, not just proud of like the song itself. Because it's one thing to be like, hear the song and be like, oh, we're proud of the song. It's another thing to like, hear the recording and be like, oh, we're proud of the actual recording of the song, you know? Mm-hmm. So we want to get to that point before we release anything. But I feel like we'll probably do singles.
It's sick to see an album be posted, but where like the energy and live, like where music, the music scene right now is just like, it's all being like TikTok singles and shit like that. It just, I don't know. If you can release a single and you can make it big, you're there. None of us have any clue, like.
So this is something that I've been saving.
You should be saving it.
Yeah.
Right. Uh-oh.
I'm looking forward to it.
All right. So.
Okay.
And I want this to be as intimate as possible.
Well, like I get stripped down.
We can out.
No, like that.
I just wanted to. Show
us. Get in here. All right. So we'll start with Max and Nick.
Yeah.
All right. So Max starts first, and then Nick.
Okay.
And you say it at the same time, though.
Wait, like, in sync synchronous or no?
Yeah, you say it at the same time to the question I'm gonna ask. Max to Nick.
I'm nervous.
Max to Nick. What is something that is, like, so important to you about him joining the band and vice versa?
Mm.
In one word... that you can sum up.
Mine's like a, there's a hyphen in mine, if that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay. That's perfect. One, two, three, go.
Lockdown. When we brought this guy in, it was like, it brought another level of rhythm where him and Owen were able to like link up and create a crazy foundation of rhythm. Yeah, the cousins have this bond, and it's like, it created a crazy foundation of rhythm for me to sit on top of, where both Matt and I were able to like build from that.
And yours was creativity.
So I've been playing music for a long time, but I will say that Max has something that nobody else has. You know,
he is incredibly creative, because he goes off, instead of going off like theory or something like that, he goes off like feel and emotion. Mm-hmm. It is insane. It is like something I would never dream of, never think of, and it's just crazy. Yeah. And Max brings that creativity, and he comes up with like the craziest things you'd never think of, and I love him for that.
Okay.
One thing I want to say is Max will always talk about his creativity in terms of like others' creativity. Max will be like, oh, you know, I heard this riff and I like based this riff that I like brought to the band off this riff, or I like poster design, oh, I saw this poster and based it off, and it's like he acts like it's like he's ripping something off, but he'll show us the song and it's like fucking
It's him. You can see
that it's in the same box. If he's doing the same, like, you know, if he based it off like this riff that he like had heard, it's in the same box. Or like, you'll see the poster and you'll be like, oh, I see, like, oh, like you took like these like lines, like accented lines that they did like off of like this poster, or like whatever the fuck it is. This font looks like similar to that poster. But he like does not give himself the credit of like his own creativity. So Max's creativity, yeah, that is like such a great fucking thing to bring.
To add on to that, lockdown doesn't have a hyphen.
That's a good one.
Oh, true.
Mine's like there's a hyphen in mine.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay. It's perfect. And Max, how do you feel hearing that?
I don't know. We don't like talk about each other's like the shit we write. Oh, I'll come up with something, or like, Owen will write a good jump part, or Nick will lay down a good bass line, but we're not sitting in the room like patting each other on the back constantly. We just kind of like move forward, and like we're constantly like moving forward, like, oh, sick riff, and then we write the song, and then we never like look back on shit each other, we like stuff we've done,
but it's all coming out now.
So like they hear that and they're like,
six beers. So like, that's how good he is.
They hear that, like, to hear like the guys step back and to like pat me on the back about that. I mean, like, it's stuff I haven't heard before, and it just feels good. I don't know.
That's nice.
It's hard to like. I don't know. It's just one of those things I haven't heard.
That's
a lot.
Important.
Yeah. And like feels good. Having been like the dude who I've played with him like the whole time we've both been playing music. It's been together. And it's like the shit he plays, it doesn't sound like what other people plays. It's his own thing.
Right.
It's so fucking cool.
And so does that give you hope for like what you're gonna become?
Yeah, dude, totally, because it means we have like our own sound. Like we don't really sound like any other bands or any other shit. Like customer service is customer service. It's nothing else.
Right.
Which is so fucking dope to me.
Yeah. And so Matt and Owen.
Okay. Are we gonna go? I got mine.
Yeah.
I got
mine.
And it's on three. You have yours?
Yeah.
You ready?
Let's do it.
Here we go.
3, 2, 1.
Love.
Energy.
For me, just having a dude like Matt in the band who's so into it and loves it so much, it makes me so happy. And also, like, I've said this to Matt before, breaking your rules a little bit, but, like I've told before, like, even if we didn't play music, like, I'd be so happy to be his friend and to have him around all the time. He's such a good dude. And like, yeah, like, and same with Nick. I mean, obviously, same with him. He's my fucking cousin. Yeah.
you got him.
With Max, I've only known him for, like, 4 months. Like, I fucking love this guy. Yeah. I love being around him.
Except he said that one time. Max was in the room. Max went, if you left the band, I'd say, fuck you, bro.
That was a joke.
Yeah, so I said energy. Owen is such a driving force in the band, and he, like, fucking always will be. He's such a, like, I mean, he's just a fucking loud dude.
Yeah.
But, like, he's got so much energy all the time. He is always, like, he's just there. He's, like, ready to go. He's, like, he believes that the band can be something. Because it's, like, we can actually be something with a guy who actually believes that the band can be something. When there's somebody who's like in the band who is we have something here, it like affirms your own, like, sometimes you have like a suspicion or like a bit of a like, oh man, do we have like something special here? And then there's this one guy who is like, we do, and he's like so confident about it makes it so easy to actually believe that you're like to be enthusiastic, to actually have the love that I have for the band, to have like the enthusiasm, and like for me to be like so happy to be a part of the band. Mm-hmm. It's so easy to be to feel that way when you have somebody who is so fucking like excited constantly.
He's
about
the soul
band.
Of it.
He's the soul of the goddamn band.
He's the soul
band,
of the band.
And I would never say that without
this
it's unreal.
We're all fucked.
And do you guys feel like you talk about this often? If you talk about what your importance is to each other?
I'm probably be crying tonight.
I love
when you guys walk into the room and we're all gonna start crying. And it's like figuring out that first. God damn it. Figuring out like the two different ideas.
This is going to shit so fast.
Spencer.
This is the first episode, man.
The beginning of an era.
Sweet home Alabama. I'm coming home to you. My sweet
Alabama. 2, 3, go.
Shout out to Liam McNeil.